You've got to find what you love. If you haven't found it yet, keep looking and don't settle.
Make sure that you are focused on something you're passionate about.
Don't follow your passion. Hi everyone, my name is Luba, and in this video, I want to explore the topic of following your passion, or rather saying that you should actually not follow your passion. I recently started listening to a podcast called Founder's Journey by Alex Lieberman, the co-founder of Morning Brew. Morning Brew is this business newsletter that's been around since, I think, about 2015. And I've been absolutely loving the podcast. It's very short form, and he kind of just shares his thoughts about his founder's journey, about his mental frameworks and whatnot. And the recent podcast was talking about this idea that following your passion is a faulty advice. And I got super inspired because I totally agreed with this message and decided to, you know, explore this message in this video and share my thoughts on it. In the podcast, Alex says that following your passion is very binary. And I'm sure you all have heard advice, which actually has been especially popular in the recent couple of decades. If you look at the graph since 1970s, they kind of did a search for how often this idea of following your passion came about every single year since the 70s, and only in the last 20 years or so this idea has really been on the rise. So I'm sure you've heard it, and I'm sure you've kind of given it a thought, thinking, what is my passion really? What is it that I've always wanted to do? Perhaps you even thought of yourself as a child and remember it. What did you respond to the question of whom do you want to become when you grow up? And I have spent my fair share of time thinking about what is my passion and that I really need to find a career and a job that I am very passionate about. But the reality is that this idea of following your passion kind of says, as Alex points out in his podcast episode, that, you know, you either have the passion or you don't. And the more you start searching for it, the more you look for that passion, the more doubt you find in, you know, is this really it? Is this the thing that I'm passionate about? It kind of makes it very single-minded that there is this right pursuit for you. There is this right, perfect dream job for you. But an interesting thing about it is that if you compare it to a relationship, it's almost like saying that there is a person in the world, the idea of the one that you just meet, you fall madly in love with, and everything is just brilliant, romantic, and perfect. Your whole life with that person and your whole relationship right from the start. But I personally do not believe in that idea. And, you know, research shows that a lot of the times that is not true. And this idea of finding the one and finding that person that we immediately fall in love with is extremely romanticized by Western culture, by Disney cartoons and whatnot. And most likely you meet a person, you get to know them, and you slowly start loving certain things about them. And that's how you fall in love, and that's how you find your passion. And the notion of following your passion is very comparable with the idea of the one, because the more you analyze it, hey, is cooking really my passion? Is it art? Is it computers? The harder it becomes to make a decision. I'm curious what worked for you guys. Have you been following your passion, or has a passion been found through you doing? Consider sharing your thoughts in the comment section down below. And of course, I'm gonna leave the link to the podcast in the video description. I truly believe that instead of following your passion, instead of sitting there and, you know, thinking, what is it in the world that I'm truly passionate about? You should be taking action, exploring your curiosity, exploring things that you think you'd be good at, exploring things that are giving you energy, and the passion will naturally come through the mastery and through you putting time into that specific thing. For the last probably 3 years, I have been enchanted by this idea of following your passion myself. And I have been really spending a lot of time trying to figure out, you know, should I become an opera singer? Is it YouTube that's my passion? Is it being an artist of some capacity? Is it being a startup founder? Is it, you know, being a chief of staff? And the only way I've realized to find my passion is to lean into things that I find curious, find interesting, and then either eliminate them as something that didn't actually turn out to be as great as I expected, or lean into them and find more not anxiety, and find more excitement around them. You might be thinking that when I finally find that dream job, when I finally find that dream activity, then I would be productive, I would be happy, I would be joyous. And the reality might hit that once you actually do enter that job space, you might hate it. Or the reality is also that you are currently living in the future, you're not living in the now. You're waiting until, you know, you make a ton of money or until you retire. You're not living your life to the fullest now. And you know, when I was actually my last couple of years at Airbnb, I was very much in that search of my passion, which made me quite distracted from the tasks at hand and from the enjoyment and learning from my colleagues, from the tasks that I was doing. So I find this idea of thinking that only if or when I'm going to be in this dream job, you're actually distracted from finding the passion in the now. The other thing that Alex and his Founders Journey podcast talks about is fluctuation of passion. And I personally think that is very similar with motivation. I truly believe that it's unreasonable to constantly look for inspiration, to constantly look for motivation, to do work, to look for that muse, because the reality is that our motivation goes up and down, and so is our passion. One day you're feeling extremely motivated, another day you feel under the weather, your energy is low, but it's your environment. It's the routine, it's your commitment and your interest that gets you going and that gets you to make progress. And the same with passion. You might think, hey, I love making dessert. And then, you know, one day you're ecstatic, you make cakes the whole day. And the next day you're just not as passionate about it because maybe something's not working out. The dough isn't rising, the cream isn't tasting the same, but that doesn't mean that you're not passionate about it. It's just because passion goes up and down. And if we're always relying on this idea of I'm either passionate about it or not, then you're gonna be jumping from one thing to another without really developing the mastery and the taste and flavor for the activity at hand. After this exploration of passion and if following a passion is truly the right path, I'm now convinced that it's following your curiosity. And I really like the framework that Alex had in his podcast of asking yourself questions. What am I good at? What kind of lifestyle do I want to have? What gives me energy and what puts me into flow? That is truly the right framework to think about the things that you should be trying and that you should be doing. And recently I found myself in a position of tending to overthink and overplan activities that I naturally have curiosity in and I have excitement to start them. And then as soon as I spend too much time thinking, hey, is this really the right thing? Is this really what I'm passionate about? Is this really gonna work out? So putting that mindset of what the future is gonna look like, I get absolutely discouraged to even start. So asking yourself those questions and taking action, proving or disproving a hypothesis of doing a certain activity and finding joy in it, I think that's the right approach for finding passion through doing, being action-oriented, being action-biased, not overthinking, not over-planning, but just doing stuff and leaning into your curiosity and into your bursts of energy and things that really feed and nurture you. I'm gonna leave you with this thought of considering not following your passion, but finding passion through doing. Consider subscribing to this channel if you enjoyed this video, and bye for now.